के 2020 रिजल्ट इज ऑलरेडी पब्लिश्ड, सम PSUs आर ऑलरेडी पब्लिश देयर नोटिफिकेशन रिगार्डिंग वैकेंसीज एंड IITs ऑल्सो रिलीज देयर फॉर्म्स फॉर एडमिशन. ओके, एट दिट मोमेंट लेट्स वी डिस्कस अबाउट द अपॉर्चुनिटीज एक्सपेक्टेड अकॉर्डिंग टू योर रैंक. मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन इज दैट फॉर द कट ऑफ वी हैव टू गिव कंसेंट्रेशन ऑन द रैंक or on the GATE score. I will suggest for the interdisciplinary branches, look at the GATE score, as because more than one branches students apply there. And for the core branches, suppose you are civil student, you are looking for only the branches where civils are eligible. So at that moment, look at the rank. Okay, for the electrical, also core branches, look at the rank. Now, let's start the rank versus opportunity. Okay, rank versus opportunity. Up to 1000 rank, chances for PSU calls is, you may get PSU calls up to 1000 rank. There's the possibility that you can get call from PSU for interview. Okay. But in this year, I'm basically discussing about the EE students. Okay, in this year, the expectation is that up to 250 rank possibility of PSU. Beyond 250, for getting a PSU, it will be a difficult. Okay, but you can expect the call for interview up to 1000 rank. Then the second opportunity is that M.Tech in IISc and old IITs like IIT Bombay, Delhi, Kharagpur, Kanpur, etc. You may get a chance up to 1500 rank. Now question comes that what is the number one opportunity, PSU or M.Tech from IIT? Okay, if you ask this question, somebody will say that PSU, but somebody will say IIT. As because I think most of the people who know that the 2017 electrical topper Shivam Singh, he got an opportunity to work in a very good PSU, but now he is pursuing M.Tech. He is doing M.Tech from IIT Bombay. What is the reason? The reason is basically that after M.Tech from the old IITs, means the top level IITs, there is also possibility of very good placements there, and also you are interested about the research, that is a very great opportunities there also. Okay, now look at this. This is a very good option, don't neglect this. This is NETI Mumbai. It is not M.Tech, it is PGDM course, means postgraduate diploma in management. Most interesting things is here is that the placement, it is 100% placement. Some of the students also get more than 2-3 job offers, and package is quite good. Average package means minimum package, you can say 10 lakhs minimum package is there. So it is also a very good opportunity up to 1500 rank. The placement of NETI Mumbai is sometimes higher than the old IITs also. Okay, now come to the next, that is up to 2000 rank M.Tech in top NITs. Top NITs means South Indian NITs like RIT Trichy, Warangal, Suratkal and Calicut. For this top 4 NITs, your rank should be below 2000. Next opportunity is up to 3000 rank MS in top old IITs. What is the difference between MS and M.Tech? MS is basically 2.5 to 3 years course, and M.Tech is strictly 2 years course. MS is mostly research related, and M.Tech is basically job related. The placement scenario of M.Tech is quite good or quite higher than the MS, but there is also possibility of placement in MS. after if you complete your MS from a old or top IITs, so you may also get placement there. And for the PhD purpose, for the research purpose, MS is good. Okay, for MS in top old IITs and MTech in top new IITs. Top new IITs means this is the second generation IITs, like IIT Hyderabad, IIT Bhubaneswar, etc. Now see, up to 6,000 rank, you may get MTech in new IITs and other NITs. Other NITs means some old NITs like NIT Durgapur, NIT Jamshedpur, NIT Raipur, NIT Kurukshetra, and new IITs like IIT Goa, IIT Jammu, maybe sometimes the IIT Mandi, etc. Okay. If your rank is more than 6,000 rank, you may go for MTech in your state universities. In the all states, there are one or two universities which conduct MTech courses. Now look at the specialty. MTech is basically specialization, which subject we have to give priority for the electrical. Okay, first priority is power electronics. Nowadays the demand of power electronics is very very high. In every institute, if you watch the cutoff of power electronics is tough. Second best option is the control, means control system related subjects. Somewhere it is control and instrumentation, maybe control and automation, these kinds of subjects. Its field is quite huge, field is there. Second is signal processing. It is also a very good subject, very good opportunity for the electrical. Also the EC students are allowed for control and signal processing both. Then power system. The subject is good, but somebody is saying that the research facilities is almost saturated in the power system. So you may give less priority to the power system, more priority to the power electronics, control, signal processing, etc. These are also the very good subjects for which the EE GATE students can apply. Look at this, VLSI embedded system. These two are the very good subjects for the placement. Maybe you have to work hard if you are from EE. Maybe you have to work hard for completing MTech in embedded and VLSI, but the placement scenario is very very good. This is basically EC related subjects, means electronics related, but EE students, IN student and EC students are eligible to apply for VLSI and embedded systems. Sometimes CSE are also eligible here. And MTech in computer science related subject from TPL IITs, electricals are also eligible, like TPL IIT Bangalore, which is a very good college. EE students are eligible. Up to 1500 rank, you may get TPL IIT's good subjects in computer science. And EE students are also eligible for communication. Okay. Now come to the priority wise colleges. Top is IISc Bangalore, no doubt. This is the topmost engineering college in India and also one of the best institute of Asia. Okay. Second one is IIT Bombay. It is also very good. Then IIT Delhi, Madras, Kanpur, Kharagpur. These all are the top IITs and old IITs. Then after this, IIT Roorkee, Guwahati, Trichy, NIT Trichy. This is the top NIT, and the placement scenario of NIT Trichy is quite similar with the top IITs. Then IIT BHU, which is Banaras Hindu University, it is also good. NIT Warangal, this is the second NIT. It is also good for placement purpose. Then IIT Hyderabad, it is a new IIT, means it is established in 2008. But it is good. It improves its infrastructure and faculty scenario high in a very short time. Okay. Then NIT Shiratkal, NIT Calicut. Some other good NITs are NIT Allahabad, Raurkela, NIT Nagpur, IIST, Shippur, it is also good, NIT Surat. and other old NITs like NIT Durgapur, Jamshedpur, Raipur, Jaipur, they are also good. Now, I am coming to the placement scenario. The question may comes in the many students' mind that how is the placement after M.Tech? Okay, first I will show you some slides, some statistical data about one good NIT and about one good IIT. Then I will discuss generally what is the placement scenario for electrical and for other streams in M.Tech. Let's see. First is, this is NIT Calicut placement, okay, from 2013-14 to 2017-18 batch, the placement statistics is given here. You may watch this, okay. First EC telecommunication, electricals are also eligible, so I am keeping this here. Look at this. Look at this very carefully, 2017-18, among the 70 students, only 2 are placed, 28%. AC signal processing, this is also a good subject, among 10 only 1 is placed in 2017-18. Look at this instrumentation and control, here is also 25% placement. Next, power system, I'm zooming here, among 17 5 are placed in 2017-18. All the placements are below 30%. You can watch power electronics, 3 among 9, okay. Power and automation, there is only 16%, 2 among 12. And for high voltage, look at this. High voltage engineering is a subject that is only present in the NIT Calicut. You will not watch this subject in other NITs, okay. Then, industrial management. Thermal science, it is not electrical related subject, but you can also still watch how is the placement is here. Okay, this is the placement about NIT Calicut. Now this is IIT Kharagpur. It's a old IIT, very good IIT. This placement statistics is only for electrical. Look at this, electrical engineering department. Okay. First, EE 4 year, this is BTEC placement. Okay, BTEC placement, very good placement, 89.5% placement. Now come to the M.Tech placement. This is, look at this, machine drives and power electronics, 2 year course written here, placement 2 among 6. It is poor placement, quite 33.3%. Look at this, control system engineering, 6 among 11, it is good. Power and energy system, 11 among 14. But you may say that why it is not 100%. One of the reason is that the students who come for M.Tech in top NITs, top IITs, some of are passionate about the PhD. Some of the students are interested about the higher studies and for research purpose. So they didn't attend the campus interview. Okay. Now let's we generalize the placement situation in the NITs. As far as the get the information, in case of top IITs, the placement scenario is good for EE students. For EE students in top IITs, okay, top IIT. Top IIT means top 8. Their placement is good. And also for NIT Trichy, the placement is good. And below that things, in case of NITs, other than top NITs, the placement situation is for the EC and CSE, the placement is very good. For the VLSI, for the embedded system, and for the computer science related subject, the placement is very good. But for the core electrical, mechanical, and the civil, the placement is less. In case of EE, what is the opportunity? What is the opportunity? In any specialization, among the 17 or 18 students, most of the times 3-4 at most 3 or 4 students get placed. The opportunity for the remaining is that they may attend the campus interview for EE. I'm discussing about EE. 3-4 get placed. Remaining, they may attend the campus interview for the CSE related companies, means IT sectors. Many companies come and many job opportunities are there, and EE M.Tech are also eligible for that. Otherwise, they can go for PhD. Obviously, if you complete your M.Tech in electrical, any specialization from a good old NIT or new IIT, you may go for PhD in top IITs if you gather good knowledge from there. Okay, so that was about the placement. So I can say the forms for IITs, most of the IITs is already published. For filling up the form, you have to register COAP, Common Offer Acceptance Portal. You have to register for COAP and then go to the site of different IITs. Suppose you want to apply for IIT Bombay, you have to go for IIT Bombay site and fill up the registration form. You will need the COAP registration number there. Okay, first register for COAP and then go for the IIT sites. And for the NIT, you have to wait for CCMT, means centralized counseling process. Okay, and another important discussion is that if you want to check from CCMT site, you may go for CCMT. Just go to the Google and search system CCMT. You will get the site of CCMT. From that site, you can check the cutoff. You can check the cutoffs of NITs. Okay, but don't worry. If you watch the 2017 and 18 cutoff, in 2017 and 18 there were GAT score quite high in case of similar ranks. Okay, in 5K rank and 2017 the score was 541, but this year in 2020 for 5K rank the score is around 500. Okay, so quite less. You can analysis by watching the rank versus score, but as I observe, you may get a chance in old NITs up to 4.5K rank. Okay, 4500 rank, you may get chance in old NITs. And for the new IITs, that is 4 to 4.5K rank. Okay, 4 to 4.5K rank, you have a chance in new IITs. Okay, another important things that is IIT cutoffs. You may get this from Medigi Telegram group. I'm just scrolling down. You just can take the screenshot or pause the video and you can watch the cutoffs. Okay, this was Bangalore, then this is for IIT Delhi, IIT Bombay, then for IIT Madras, IIT Roorkee is also there, IIT Kanpur, IIT Kharagpur, then for Guwahati, IIT BHU, that is Varanasi, then IIT Hyderabad. This is new IIT, but cutoff is quite high. This is quite good at right now. IIT Gandhinagar cutoff will be quite less. Okay, just 592. It was in the previous year for 584 score, the rank was 5000, so 592. It is, you can expect around 4500. I already discussed up to 4500 there is a possibility of new IIT. IIT Patna 544, higher than 5K rank according to 2019. Okay, IIT Jodhpur 584, 520. So this is around, means somewhere more than 5000 rank for the new IITs. IIT Bhubaneswar, it is also good. The rank is around 3500. Okay, IIT Dhanbad. It was previously ISM. Now it is converted into IIT. Its cutoff is around, you can expect the rank 2500 to 3000. Then IIT Roper, IIT Mandi, very less cutoff is here. Okay. In the IIT, sometime the IIT conduct the interview and also exam. So if your rank is quite high, you may take a chance. If you get an interview call and exam call, and if you perform better in the interview and the exam, there is also a possibility. Okay. IIT Jammu, very less cut up. It is also not good IIT. Okay. NITI Mumbai. Okay. This is CCMT site. Look at this site. This is cmt.nic.in. Then go for the previous year cutoff, and you have to choose the year from here. 2018, 17, 16. 3 years cutoff are available here for the round 1, 2, 3, and then NSA round. If the after the third round some seats remain vacant, then go for NSA round. So if you want to check your opportunity at your score and rank, just watch the round 3, okay? Not go for NSR, because very less subjects, very less department, go for NSR round. If that remain vacant, then select institute, NIT Tiruchirappalli, suppose I am selecting, then branches, okay? Here are the branches, you can choose branches like suppose Power Electronics, then click the submit button, you can watch. For general, it was 723 minimum score. For OBC, 7676. For SC, quite less, 536. Okay. And the important things, that is, for many of the IITs, the criteria is CGPA, that is 6.5 CGPA or 60%. Okay, don't calculate the CGPA or percentage according to your university rule. The rule is for CCMT and for some IITs, that is 60% and 6.5 CGPA for general and OBC category. For SCST, that is 55% and 6 CGPA. Here is the NIT cutoffs, means CCMT cutoffs. Okay, this is for 2019. You will not get this from CCMT site. You can check it from Medigi Telegram group. Okay, was this for NIT Trichy? It is quite high, similar like IIT. And beside this, NIT Warangal, Suratkal, Calicut, Allahabad, Rourkela, Jaipur, Bhopal, Surat, etc. are there. For the OBC, the cutoff is also there. First for general category, then for OBC, then for SC. Okay. This is for SC category, then for ST, NIT Goa, NIT Nagaland, Arunachal Pradesh, 6 NITs are there in the northeast. For very less KT score, you may get. Okay, among the northeast, NIT Silchar and NIT Agartala, these two are good. But remaining, the NITs are not so good, infrastructure is not so good. Communication system from the central India to the northeast is not good. NIT Allahabad, good NIT. NIT Jalandhar, it is also old NIT. PEC, Punjab Engineering College, it is quite good. It is similar like NITs. Chandigarh is a very good city. IST Howrah, it is also good. So that is the discussion about the after GATE 2020 opportunities. Okay, so if you have any query, you may write in the comment box. Okay, thank you.